Looks to be your lucky day, my friend.
Only has room for one.
Not likely, bootlickers. Initiate skip jump.
Sweet. I wonder if they can track him. Or they just have no idea where he is now. Terra 2 orbiting laboratory.
Status. Structural integrity down 25%. Power levels down
25%. Shit.
Did I get out?
There you are. Wondering what's going on, eh? Bit of bad news there, I'm afraid. Your colony ship was inexplicably knocked out of skip space and forced to complete its journey at sublight speeds. This means that you and every other colonist on the Hope have been in suspended animation for 70 years, give or take. Normally, reviving someone after so long leads to some quite horrifying results. It's called explosive cell death, but it's really more of a liquefaction. Something wrong? Oh, yes, well, not to worry. I've pumped your body full of a special concoction I devised to keep you from dying so horrifically. Hopefully at all, but I guess we'll see, yes?
Are you welding me into this thing?
I used the last of my chemical supplies saving you. I know it's a lot to ask, but I must have your help securing more if we're to save the rest of your fellow colonists. I'd see it done myself, of course, but the board has a sizable bounty on my head. Now, my ship is inoperative, but I've managed to hire a smuggler to help you out. He'll be... Oh, I see we're in position. Good luck!
A smuggler? Things don't work so good around here. Chairman Rockwell raises a glass to our lost brothers and sisters. 60th anniversary of the Hope's disappearance. Remember the Hope. Tactical time dilation. Charge up weapons like the plasma rifle will consume more ammo the longer
charge. Is this thing working? Ah, there you are. Now, where were we? Oh, yes, the smuggler. His name is Hawthorne, and he should be waiting for you at the landing site. He's to be your chauffeur, so to speak. Not to worry. I'm told he's a specialist. Dashing gunslinger, one-of-a-kind ship, that sort of thing. You'll like him, I'm sure. I've also outfitted you with a simple wireless monitor, so I can track your progress. I'll check in with you as soon as you land. Good luck. All the colonists are counting on you.
Well, hopefully, they're not screwed.
Ah, you landed. Good. Hawthorne should be close by. What in law's name? Is that him? Oh, that idiot.
Oops.
I told him to plant the beacon and move away, not stand there holding it. Oh well, no sense in letting his ship go to waste. Hawthorne won't mind you taking his ship. Better you than the board, huh? Not sure I trusted the fellow. Might have gone after the bounty on my head. Shame about the whole squashing thing. Nasty way to go.
Yeah, how sad, huh? Alright, I have got to decrease the mouse just a bit. Okay, maybe that requires a little too much movement. Bear with me here, guys. Just... there's a lot of difference. Five, I guess. Wow, look at that. Push. Is there anything around to, like, be analyzed, or... things move weird around here, don't they? Jumping. Sneaking. Sprinting. I want to go back. No, no going back. Can't really jump that high at all. So there's nothing around here to be seen, I guess. And I don't have a weapon. How about inventory? There's me! I look better. Light ammo. Spacer's choice. Vulcan. Firefly. Energy cell. High energy electrochemical cell pack used to power energy-based weapons. Light up your opposition with Firefly's line of pure energy-based ammunition. Backed by Vulcan's 800-meter lethality guarantee and the most cost-effective solution to any threat. Aramid ballistics will keep your skin intact. Armor management. Drag armor or helmet items up to the equipment slots to wear them. You can also manage your armor here. Break them down. Inspect them. Compare to other armor. Tag them as junk or drop them. Alright, well, I just have this. Hibernation suit. Armor 3. This suit is designed to be used in hibernation pods, standard gear for every colonist making the long journey to Halcyon. Nothing to compare, so... T&L makes the best gear for your friends and family. Consumables. Here you can use junk or drop your consumables. It can be used directly to gain a variety of boosts. Your emergency medical inhaler is shown at the top of the screen. It uses Adreno as fuel to heal you in an emergency and always keeps it loaded into slot 1. Increase your medical skill to unlock more drug mixing slots that can hold all type of consumables, not just Adreno. Each slot is mixed into every puff of the inhaler for combined effect. Your medical skill increases the duration of all these effects. Alright, so there's the inhaler. Activates all slotted consumables simultaneously, allowing you to quickly treat injuries and enhance your abilities. For all your emergency medicinal inhaling needs, if you are hurt but cannot breathe, see a doctor. Injectable healing enhancer. Heals 25% over 2 seconds. So I can use this stuff now. I have this now. Modifications, none. General. Quests. Junk. Alright. Phineas needs your help to set things right in Halcyon, but you'll need transportation first. Find Hawthorne's ship. The smuggler took your meeting location a bit too literally. Guess that means his ship is yours now, if you can find it. Botched? You can have botched quests. Map. Cool. Ooh, I can zoom it. Nice. Player location. Can I mark stuff? No. Emerald Vale, yeah, that's where we are. Oh, Codex. We have a Codex? There's a Codex. Oh, good God. the basics. Use to go underneath obstacles and to sneak, crouching, dodging. Double click the jump button to dodge left, right, or backwards. Really? Falling damage. Be careful. Falling can be deadly. Hunger. You're hungry and you need to eat. Supernova difficulty. You must eat every few hours. Without eating, your hunger will get worse over time in 4 stages, reducing your strength, charm, and perception at each stage until eventually death. Jump over obstacles. You have unlocked leap. Double click jump when moving forwards to leap forward. Really? I want to try some of that stuff. Double click. Wait, double click that? Wait. So double click and then jump. How do I get there? Journal? Double click the jump button. Dodge left, right, or back. Double click jump. Well, if I go jump, nothing. Oh, hey, that was better. Maybe it's just because I'm going downhill. That is a little better, isn't it? Alright. Is that a little animal? Aw. Yeah. Soon we'll be finding big animals. Leap dodge. Resting in a bed is relaxing and moves time forward in supernova difficulty. Yeah. Sleep deprivation. Sprint. Thirst. Same thing. Exploration. Some objects explode when hit. Shoot them when enemies are nearby for an explosive surprise. Just don't be too close. Explosion can cause concussions. You can fast travel to locations you have unlocked by opening your map and selecting the destination. Objective markers in your HUD and on the compass help you navigate to your current quest objective. Some people may require completing another quest before they will assist you. You can check your quest log for dependencies. Quest dependencies. That's the first time I've seen that. Quest tracking. Quest tracker displays objectives. Loot. Always shown at the top of the screen. Okay. Oh, I see that. Is that the F? F is the inhaler, yeah. I'll probably change that at some point. You cannot sprint or fast travel while encumbered. Sell, drop, or break down items in your inventory to reduce your carry weight. Display in the top left of the ledger. Okay, so there. Your hacking and lockpick skills help you get into places you're not meant to be. Mag picks are used to break open locks, and bypass shunts are used to break computer encryptions. If your skill is high enough to break security, we'll see how many mag picks or shunts you need and how long it will take. Raising your skill will lower the number of items used and speed up the process. All right. Junk items. You can quickly break down all your junk items at a workbench or sell in bulk to a vendor. You can flag them as junk. Picking locks. Looting. Corpses in containers. Masswheel scrolls. Okay, merchant skill. Use to negotiate prices and buying and selling from vendors. Some vendors and vending machines have special items that are only for sale to VIPs. You must have a positive reputation to be able to purchase those items. A high hack skill can bypass this restriction and allow purchasing of these items from a vending machine. Right, we have this. We can sell items to the vending machine. We get to 40 or higher, we can get to restricted items for high enough reputation. Or either one, okay. The bits gained or spent for the whole transaction keep updating as you add items to each side. Stocks update every few days. Mm-hmm. It wanted me to see this for some reason. Drag armor or helmet items up to the equipment slots to wear them. Aren't I wearing my thing already? N-rays. Bombard enemies with N-rays. When an enemy takes enough N-ray damage, they start damaging those around them. Huh. I wonder what N and the N is for. Charge up weapons. Hold the attack button to build up energy, then release to attack. We can have broken items. Oh man. Item degradation. Ah. Repair them yourself or have a vendor do it. Item repair. A small percentage of weapons and armor you may find are considered pristine. They have more durability and are worth more to vendors. Can be identified by a diamond near their condition meters. Science weapons are unique weapons that have strange and powerful effects. Special weapon effects. Tinkering. There's a lot to see. Tells you if they're unaware, suspicious, investigating, or alerted. Huh. Companions. Companion wants to talk. A thought bubble. Try talking to them. Huh. Alright, so it's telling me... Oh, basic movement. Well, I know that. And it was trying to tell me this too. Armor management. Oh my. So I already had it on, obviously. I don't know why it was telling me that. I only have one at a time. That's locked. Okay. Alright. Guys are cute. Why? Why do I have to sprint? Am I have to run from something? Saving, okay. It's telling me how to sprint. Marauder thug. Sneaking, use tall grass, rocks, or other stuff. Covering. Yeah, I hear something. That's what it is I'm seeing there. Timid canid. The awareness meters tell you if they're unaware, suspicious, investigating, or alerted. Right. But what's it look like? What's this? I'm guessing it's this? The, or is it the red? Codex might tell me. Stealth. Here we go. Well, I don't know then. You're not telling me. Sprint, crouch. Just clearing the little... I'm gonna be coming out of... What's going on?
You see now, you've been frozen for a while. There's bound to be unforeseen side effects.
That startled me. I was like, what the hell is happening to me? Yeah, I am sneaking for the rest of the way. After seeing those things, I have no gun, no weapon, nothing. I don't know if I can punch somebody or something. I think I'm going to be falling down there. Can I reach that, though? Phineas, can I make this jump? I mean, is that even... a place... that I can stand? I don't think that's even a place I can stand. No, it wasn't. I have low health. Okay. No, I heard someone cough. Was that me? Sound like... Yeah, someone ahead. Friend or foe? There's a person over there. A coughing person.
Hey, you! Come here!
How'd you see me? What you got here?
You've tried the best now. Now try the rest. Spacer's choice. Oh, wow, that stinks.
Huh. Sit still, I'll patch you up.
Looks like the bleeding stopped. I owe you one. Hope you don't mind me omitting this little exchange from my report. Spacer's choice doesn't like us accepting outside help.
Oh, geez. Everyone needs help now and then. What happened to you?
We were out on patrol. I saw a marauder camp up in the hills. Thought I could take him. Then my gun misfired. Right through my side. I mean, what are the odds of that, right? Just barely scraped by with my life. Crawled in here and blocked off the exit with those canisters.
Quality merchandise. What are you doing out here?
Investigating an illegally grounded ship. All spacecraft must arrive and depart from authorized landing pads. That's board law, that is. Some hullhead grounded their spacecraft out in the open. That's a real good way to attract marauders. See those canisters by the entrance? Marauders come sniffing around in here, and I can take them all out with a single shot. Not bad, huh?
So we don't have any other choice other than to... Yeah. I don't have any other choice other than to try to persuade him, lie to him, or intimidate him. I've got a better idea. Give me your gun, and I'll go get help.
Yeah, okay. You look like you know your way around a gun. Got some spare ammo, not counting the bullet in my side. Here, you can have my saber too, for patching me up and all. All Spacer's Choice weapons are now 30% less likely to malfunction. You've tried the best, now try the rest. Spacer's Choice. Yes, nailed it that time.
What are you, a walking advertisement? Can you tell me where I am?
You hit your head or something? You're in Emerald Vale. We're a Spacer's Choice community.
I might have.
Edgewater's a little ways down. Prettiest place in the Vale. Be sure to stop by a provisioner's for a can of our famous salt tuna.
Edgewater's, huh? Do you know anything about the Hope?
The Hope? Is that some sort of fancy new drug? Are you with Auntie Cleo or something?
Who?
Don't take this the wrong way or nothing, but I'm not allowed to fraternize with Cleo workers. Company policy.
What does this symbolize? Oh, a history of... Okay. That's cool. I like that. I notice I can ask this again, but I can't ask the other question again.
You hit your head or something? You're in Emerald. Edgewater's a little ways down.
Add him off. Cool. Okay. Ooh, what we got? Sliced bread? B-R-E-D. Bread. Tartarus sauce? Magpix? Nice. Fast ration pill.
Thanks for patching me up.
Anything else I can pick up? So I'm apparently going to be fighting marauders. So I just move this stuff, or I can just jump over it? A loaf of sliced bread. It tastes fresh because it was. Inspect. A tangy sauce made with real atmospheric contaminants from Tartarus. Sweet. Oops. Fast ration pill. Provides flavorless sustenance only. Now in brown. So that's our adreno enhancer thingy. Gotta love it. Hibernation suits like this one have not been seen in Halcyon since the first colonists arrived on the Groundbreaker. Weapon management. You can have up to 4 weapons equipped at a time by dragging them up the slots at the top of the screen. On this page, you can also inspect your weapons, compare them, flag them as junk, or break them down for parts. Players with an engineering skill can repair weapons on the screen as well. Take care of your TNL weapons, and they'll take care of your enemies. A fast-firing ballistic pistol with high accuracy and a fast reload. That's good. That's probably the most common handgun in the entire colony. It's not a bad little gun, and it's a great source of parts. And there's that saber. This melee weapon is standard issue to military recruits who are taught swordplay before being taught ranged combat. Coated with Spacer's Choice, patented, never dull finished, this blade stays durable for at least 20 swings. Can I drag that into 2? Okay. Modifiable to deal every type of damage, allowing for versatility against all kinds of flora and fauna. This I can't inspect, so I have 102 of that. So if I shoot these, I go boom. Just out of curiosity.
Can you hear me? What in the hell? This.
Haha. Yeah, something like that. Oof. Hibernation complications detected. Tactical time dilation. Due to complications stemming from being revived after an extended hibernation, your brain processes time differently. Pressing the tactile time dilation button slows down the world, giving you time to think as well as take action. You have a limited time in this mode. Standing still drains your meter very slowly, while moving and attacks drains it faster. Refreshes slowly over time, so Q for that. Do I get to see how? That's what the purple meter is, underneath my red health bar. These aren't humans. They don't sound human-like. Marauder goon. Where's the other one? Over here. What's the time dilation again? I forget. Big cartridge, light ammo, rebuilt mining gear. It was Q. I thought it was Q. That guy came up quickly. Cool. I like XP. Hacking and picking locks. So I need what? Stuff they don't have, I guess. Zero G brew. Mag pick, okay. Tarmac and cheese? Are you tarmac and cheese? Oh my god. Love it. Telescoping staff? The weapon switch button allows you to rotate between the weapons. The iconic Spacer's Choice telescoping staff can be modified many ways for additional cost. Now available in Mark II. Useful for bludgeoning various things. It can be modified to deal many kinds of damage types. Damage type. Damage 51. It does more damage than the other thing. And block, got it. Sweet. I love it. Alright, what are the goodies that I find? Is that it? Also got a fish sticks. And some kind of porta potty here. I know I'm continuously sneaking. So now we got 0G brew made in space. An ale that's good for what ails you. Love it. And tarmac and cheese. It's not real tarmac or real cheese. Cooks in less time than it takes a space pilot to land. Excluding crashes and force majeures. And fish sticks. As always, the first ingredient is salt tuna. Fun for kids. Some filler added. Made from real marine ingredients. Well, Spacer's Choice makes a lot of different products, don't they? I don't know exactly. Oh, more bread. I don't know exactly what this is. It looks like a porta potty, but I can't get into it. I mean, who would want to? But ooh, a mock apple. Another mag pick. Bunch of nanners. Cool. I wouldn't have seen that if I didn't stop sneaking. Fresh means good. Bunch of nanners. Wow, something weird happened to them at the end. One medium-sized mock apple. Real mock apple, real mock taste. Is that my health, that yellow wiener? I don't know. But I didn't see it go up. Well, bit cartridge, Adreno, light ammo, and light pistol. Is that the same pistol as the one I have? Yeah. So apparently it's empty. Well, I know we haven't really got that far. I'm mostly just looking at everything. I really don't know what all the stuff on the top, the HUD at the, on the in the left-hand corner. The red is my health. The purple is the, you know, time dilation thing. I'm not sure what the one is. If that's, I'm level one and that's my XP to the next level. And then F uses times 13 I have of these things. Oh no, I have rebuilt mining gear. Marauder armor. This mining gear has seen some hard times in a sulfur pit somewhere. You can just smell it. I really want to be wearing that. Stealth skills plus 5. I don't think I want to wear the smelly stuff. I'll just keep it as is for now. We have space bar. Plus 2 is telling me. And then Q. Yeah, I guess. Yeah. Alright, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.